Their school was built on stilts to rise above floodwaters, but all this week, the kids couldn't get through the parking lot to get into the school.
Yeah, until this morning. For the first time, students were allowed back at Riverview East Academy in the East End, and News 5's Andrew Setters was there, new at 6.
You can see how high the river came during the flooding. It's all down now here at Riverview East Academy, and the kids are back in class. It wasn't long ago that Riverview East Academy looked like this.
One day it was no water. The next day it was just flooded. So it happened overnight.
But today kids were walking to class through a parking lot they would have had to wade through during the worst of the flooding. It forced the whole school and staff to relocate to a vacant school building in Avondale for about a week.
Oh, I think it's great. It was a long week, but we made it through it.
A big welcome home on the door out front as they walked in, and it's back to the normal routine.
Good morning, Riverview staff and students. Welcome home. I see a lot of smiling faces this morning, and I know that everyone is glad to be back in our home building.
Even with all the excitement of getting back into their building, kids have to get right back to work. Seniors at this K-12 school had to take a state test in social studies today. No break for them, even though they had to deal with the hassle of the flood.
Looks like another day back at Riverview. All the students are showing up, and every one of them is telling me it's good to be home again.
This is the first time this newly rebuilt school building has been closed because of the high water, and everyone's hoping it will be the last time for a long time.
And everyone have a good day here today at Riverview East. Thank you.
There's still plenty of debris on the school grounds that needs to be cleaned up. The school itself never got wet, and the kids are now back where they belong. From Riverview East Academy, Andrew Setters, News 5.